Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how you can easily run any C program in your Sublime Text editor. So let's begin. Now to run your C program in Sublime Text editor, you need to first install two software. One is MinGW compiler and another is Sublime Text itself. So for that you need to just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar you need to just simply type MinGW Distro, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this MinGW Distro is basically our first search result. So now just click on this MinGW Distro, and this will be going to redirect you to this official site of distro. I'll be putting this link in the description so you don't need to worry about the link and all, right? And here under this download section you'll be getting this two icon, basically two link. So MinGW17.1.exe and another is MinGW17.1 without git.exe. So here what I'll be suggesting you is to download this MinGW17.1 without git.exe. So just simply click on that, and this is going to start downloading our MinGW without git. So just simply cancel it since I have already downloaded it. So I'm going to simply cancel it. So our MinGW is now downloaded, right? So now the next tip is we need to also download our Sublime Text itself. So for that you need to just simply type Sublime Text, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this sublimetext.com is basically our first search result. So just simply click on that, and you'll be getting this official site of Sublime Text, and here you can clearly see our latest version is Sublime Text 4. So just simply click on download for Windows, and this is going to start downloading our Sublime Text. Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it, and if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see our MinGW 17.1 without git has been rightly downloaded over here, along with Sublime Text build. The latest build basically has been also rightly downloaded over here. So we need to install these two software. So first, let's first install MinGW. So just simply double click on it, and this is going to open this window. In here, you need to just simply click on this triple dot, and then you need to just simply scroll down a bit, and then you need to just simply click on local disk C. So just simply select that, and then just simply click on OK, and then just simply click on extract. So this is going to start extracting our MinGW 17.1 without git. So it has rightly started. It will take maybe a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after extracting our MinGW 17.1. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now as you can clearly see, our MinGW has been rightly extracted. So if you just simply go to our C drive, you'll be getting this MinGW folder over here. Right, so just simply go inside that folder and see all files has been rightly extracted over here. So just simply click on this bin folder first, and then you need to just simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. And then you need to just simply click on this search icon, and here you need to just simply type environment. And then you'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just simply click on that, and this is going to open the system properties. Now just simply click on environment variables, then you need to just simply click on path under this user variables, right? Then just simply click on edit, then new, then right click on it and paste. Yeah, so we are basically going to first extract our MinGW in our C drive, and then we are basically going to copy that bin file location, and then just simply basically going to paste over here. So now just simply click on OK, then again OK, then again OK. So we have rightly installed our MinGW. So now it's time to install our Sublime Text. So here is our Sublime Text installer. So just to install our Sublime Text, just simply double click on it, and this is going to launch our Sublime Text. So you need to just simply click on yes to provide administrative privileges, and you can clearly see our Sublime Text installation wizard has been rightly opened over here. So let us first minimize our download directory, and then this is basically our installation wizard. Then just simply click on next. So it is telling that whether we want to add explorer text menu. So I don't want to add now, so just simply click on next. So now it's telling that it is ready to be installed. So just simply click on install to basically start installing our Sublime Text. So it is just a very small file, just an 18 MB file. So it will going to install at a very rapid pace. So it has, you know, rightly installed. So just simply click on finish. Right. And now if you just simply go to our search icon and just simply type Sublime, you'll be getting this Sublime Text over here. So just simply click on that, and this will, you know, going to open our Sublime Text. So our Sublime Text has been rightly launched over here. Now you need to just simply click on file, then open folder, and this will, you know, going to open this document directory. So you need, if it open in some other directory, you need to navigate it to document folder over here, and then just simply click on new folder. Right. So let's give a folder name as cprog, and then just simply go inside that folder, and now let's first select this folder. So this will, you know, going to create our cprog folder over here. You can clearly see it has, you know, right, created over here. Now it's time to create a new file. So where we'll be writing our C program. So for that, just simply click on file, then new file. Right. And here we are basically going to write a simple hello world C program. So hash include stdio.h and then int main. So that is basically our main method. Right. And in here we are basically going to printf what? Hello world. Right. Yeah. So just, you know, simply end with a semicolon, then go to file, then save. So this will, you know, going to open this window inside your cprog folder that you have created. So let's give the file name as prog.c. Right. And to just, you know, set this save as type to all file type. So just simply keep everything as a default, then just simply click on save. And you can clearly see our prog.c has been, you know, rightly saved over here. Right. So now if you just simply go to our this document directory, then cprog, you'll be getting this prog.c has been rightly saved over here. So right. So now you need to just simply click on this address bar and then just simply type cmd, then enter. And this will, you know, going to open our command prompt right at our cprog directory. Here you need to just simply type gcc, then the name of our file. So what is the name of our file? Prog.c. Right. So just simply type that prog.c, then enter. And we have some typo, sorry, it will be stdio.h. So just simply correct that, and if you just simply compile our program once again, you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly compiled over here. Right. And it has, you know, rightly generated a file called a. So if you just simply type over here a, then enter, you can clearly see this output hello world has been, you know, rightly shown over here. Right. So in this way, you can easily install MinGW compiler in your industrial operating system, and you can easily run your C program from your Sublime Text editor. Right. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.